Hey creatives, welcome to my channel. This is Sammi Says Create, and this is a channel where I do all sorts of DIY and creative projects and I bring you along for the ride. So welcome to my mini series. This is 5 minute fat quarters, and this is a series where I show you some fun and fabulous fat quarter makes in 5 minutes or under. No frills, no fluff, just fat quarter. So without further ado, let's go on with today's fat quarter make. So in today's video, I'm going to show you how to make this super, super cute mini bag. I've got loads of Disney fat quarters, so that is what I'm going to be using myself for this make. So you will need one full fat quarter in total to make this bag. I have chosen to have a different fat quarter for the lining, therefore I'm going to use 2 fat quarters and cut them in half. You will also need a little bit of scrap fabric for the handle as well. In addition to this, you'll need a ruler, some chalk, some fabric scissors, some clips or pins, and you'll need a sewing machine. First, you need to measure your fat quarter and cut it in half, or both your fat quarters if you're using 2. Then you need to measure and cut out the handle. So I did mine 16 inches long by 3 inches wide, but you can alter this if you feel like you want a bigger or a smaller handle. And you will need 2 of these cut out. So to carry on making our handles, you will need to fold the material in half just to crease it. You can iron it here if you find it easier and it stays a little bit better. This material was quite good at staying in place. You're then going to open it up, and you're going to fold them in half again. And then just fold that whole thing in half again, if that makes sense. Then clip or pin this just to keep it nice and secure. And we're going to do one long straight stitch across the side where the 2 sides are open. And that will just secure it into place. You're then going to take the fat quarter that you want to be on the outside of the bag, and that's going to face upwards. Then measure and pin equally the ends of the handle just to the top of the bag. Make sure the pin is slightly further down, so it makes sure it's not right at the top of the material, as we are going to stitch over these handles. The handles need to be facing towards the middle of the material, and don't forget that if you've got a pattern on your material, just keep an eye on which way the pattern needs to go, if it does need to go a certain way. The middle of this material is going to be the bottom of the bag. We have our handles all pinned equally, and now we need to use the other half of the material and place it on top. So again, the pattern is facing upwards, and just match this as neatly as you can. Again, clip or pin just to make it nice and secure, and then we're going to do 2 lots of straight stitches from top to bottom on these shorter edges. Then open up your material and bring those 2 seams that you've just stitched into the middle, so both matching pieces of material should be on either side, and just iron down that hem flat, and do this on both sides. Then going to clip or pin just those 2 longer edges together, and we're going to do 2 straight stitches across these longer edges. So make sure you leave a little gap on whichever side you want the lining to be at the end, just so we can flip it the other way around. We are now all sewn up, and I'm going to use that hole that we left just to flip the bag the other way around. So just do a little top stitch over the top of that hole just to seal it up. And this is where we simply push the side of the material that's supposed to be the lining into the other side, which is the outside of the bag. Now just flip the whole thing inside out so that the lining is on top, and bring the corners together the opposite way to which they naturally fall, as you can see here, and draw a line diagonally across about 1 inch from the bottom on either side. And then just go ahead and sew across that line. To finish off, just to add a little bit more of a professional touch, just top stitch across the top of the bag. Do 2 lines of top stitch, roughly about 1/2 inch apart, and it'll just add to it a little bit more. And we have our finished bag. So I initially found this on Pinterest, so I'll pop a link down below to the actual pin that I found it on, but it's such a fab idea and a really quick, easy fat quarter to make.
So I hope you've enjoyed today's video and you're enjoying this mini series. Please drop me comments down below and let me know what you think. If you have enjoyed it, please do show me some love and hit that like button down below, the subscribe button and the notification button, and that way you will not miss out on any of my future videos. Feel free to follow me on Instagram to see all my other crafty makes. So I will see you in the next 5 minute fat quarter video. Until then, keep creative. Bye.